How do you know me? How do you know how I feel? How?
The stars bring life. The wind caresses. The earth embraces. Flowers bloom. Life thrives. And who disturbs that circle? Humans.
Those darn humans.
Come, child of Fodra. Help us kill the humans.
Is that what you're after?
Die, humans.
No, you? Alright, we gotta fight a bunch of little queens. Oh my word. Normally a pretty annoying boss. We'll see how it goes. I might... Honestly, I think I'm gonna toss out the all divide out the gate. I've got 8 left. Bum, bum, bum. Alright, little queens. You will not take Sophie alive. Yeah, farewell, farewell. Oh, Hubert's already dead. Alright, all divide was the right call. Oh, let's go, Richard. Get those combos. Okay, all divide was the right call. I might honestly all divide for like every single little queen skirmish. Easy dodge. When I first played this, I thought she was saying I love you, but she's actually saying I loathe you. I was a teenager, what'd you expect? Yeah, farewell, no you. Oh, Elithric, you say? How do you guys feel about Lunar Requiem? Let's go. Gamer moment. I'm gonna even get a Divine Conqueror. This day can't get any better. Oh, did we already get, like, down the one little queen? Alright. Well, this the All Divide just made this, like, not difficult at all. But that's fine, because we're gonna have to fight little queens again.
There's no end to them. Sophie, no! Come back!
Come, child. We, all of us, we will ease your loneliness. Stay with us forever, an eternity, without sadness.
Eternity without sadness.
Sophie, no!
Humans.
Don't.
Oh, this is bad.
Die.
What? It's Lambda.
Lambda protected us?
We await you, child of Fodra.
She's waiting.
Come on, Sophie.
Okay.
That little queen fight went a lot better than I thought it would. Y'all divide, like, definitely made that. I mean, they didn't really kill me all that much, and I still tore through them. I know you fight more little queens, though, so, like, again, I think the other ones are just gonna be harder. Actually, I think the second little queen fight is ironically easier than the first, which you'll see why in a second. But anyway, what do we have all the way down here? Dude, that literally connected with the shuttle. Did you really need to... Kind of makes me think, like, did they really need to have that looping dungeon? Kind of makes it seem pointless. Like, we could have just taken this little path. Although, I guess they didn't really know where she was calling from, but still. It's just, like, such a slap in the face to be like, oh.
Sai, is the shuttle fixed?
It was closer than we thought.
What should we do now?
I kind of want to check out the data I took from the lab.
Then perhaps we should return to Telos Aztu.
I think some rest will do us all a world of good.
You must be tired too, right, Sophie? You should get some rest. Asbel?
Right. Let's go back to Telos Aztu.
Alright. Is there a skit I have to watch? I think we're good, actually. No, we're fine on skits. Back to Telos Aztu.
Should we examine the data first?
There's probably a machine around here that can play it back.
Are you thinking about what that girl said?
Don't be fooled by her words, Sophie. They were designed to lower your defenses.
Hey, why don't you come rest with me? It's okay. I'm fine. But...
Okay, but if you need anything, just ask.
Good talk. I think we have to go to Emerald's room, the room where we met Emerald, to progress the story.
The city appears safe for now.
But we'll be hard-pressed if any more of those monsters show up.
Yes, and it's only a matter of time until they do.
I'm concerned. If left unchecked, these creatures could wipe out all of Affinia, too.
Okay, that should do it.
All members of the second research team have perished. They brought these samples back with their lives. We cannot let them go to waste.
I agree. Very well. Proceed with the research. The core's current structure is similar to that of an immune system. So it's as if Fodra is trying to rid itself of a virus.
And in this scenario, the virus is...
Yes, I'm afraid so. The Little Queen's target is none other than humanity itself.
Why? Why has Fodra forsaken us? How could this have happened?
It's only a matter of time until the Little Queen arrives. Get out now, while you still can.
No, sir. We are going to stay with you until the end.
Then I assure you, you won't be here much longer.
Sir, I'm afraid we have no choice but to shut down Fodra's core.
But that will set the entire planet on a path to ruin.
Sir, if we don't, there won't be any humans left on the planet.
However...
Sir, there's still hope. We still have Afinia. We can survive this.
Very well. Shut down the core.
We are here. We have heard your decision.
Little Queen! Please, have mercy! Give us more time! We just want to live!
Die, human.
Little Queen doesn't play around. She's out for blood.
Destroy humanity. That is the reason for which we exist.
Yeah, okay. Humans are very flawed. It's Gaia all over again.
Was that all real?
As far as I can tell, that all happened about 1,000 years ago.
Why did Fodra turn on them?
Good question, but one that can wait. We have more pressing concerns right now.
Right. We need to find a way to stop the Little Queens.
Is that even possible?
Well, I mean, we could try shutting down the core or whatever.
That's what those scientists said in the video.
But did they succeed? It seems that they were killed before they could act.
Well, Fodra's core was shut down for almost 1,000 years. They must have found a way.
Well, I kinda sorta have an idea. But it involves Lambda.
Interesting. If we have Lambda absorb the core's Eleth...
But... what would happen to Asbel?
I would be unharmed, but I can't speak for you.
This is the classic end of the game, protagonist might die. It happens in Berseria and Abyss, where Luke and Velvet are like... about, like, could potentially die from, like, you know, going to whatever the final dungeon is.
If I absorb the core's Eleth, it will pass through both your mind and your body. The strain would be too much for a fragile human to withstand. If anything were to go wrong, your body and mind would be completely obliterated.
Why didn't that happen to Richard?
Richard's body and his mind were almost completely under my control.
So a normal human can't handle the Eleth, but you can. Is that right?
What are you planning?
Lambda, I need a favor.
You are not hearing me, human. This procedure will utterly destroy you.
No, it won't.
It's too dangerous to rely on Lambda. And even if we did, Asbel could be torn apart in the process.
It's okay. I can do this.
You mustn't.
Don't be a fool. Think about what you're saying.
I have. I'm going to let Lambda take over temporarily.
What?
Asbel, have you really considered this? Like, have you really given this some thought? I don't think you have.
You're going to voluntarily let Lambda take control? That's madness!
It's not madness, Captain.
Don't do this!
Yeah, I played Tales of the Abyss. Everything's gonna work out.
Lambda will absorb you, just as he did to me.
If that happens, you won't be Asbel anymore.
Oh, please don't play unspoken feelings. This track is too sad. I can't handle it. I'm still thinking about the scene where Sophie talks about everyone dying.
Guys, I'm just lending it to him. It's not permanent. And after I give up control, Lambda can absorb the Elith and seal it inside himself.
Because Elith is only dangerous during the period where it's flowing. So Asbel's going to offer himself to Lambda for just that little bit of time. That would minimize the strain for sure, but...
Won't absorbing all that Elith allow Lambda to become active again?
That's a good point.
Do you really believe Lambda will just hand your body back once he's done?
Yes. Lambda went out of his way to save us. We all saw it.
I pressed X too fast on Asbel's words, but I only cut off like three of his words.
If he was willing to do that, I'm willing to put my trust in him. Besides, we don't really have a choice. We have to shut down Fodra's core.
There's no doubt that Elith from the core is responsible for the new monsters around here.
And I bet it's responsible for the monsters on Afinia, too.
Asbel is correct. One way or another, we have to shut it down.
So that's why Lambda and I have to try.
What if it doesn't work? What if it fails and you're not you anymore?
I'll be fine.
How can you be so sure?
I told you I wanted to give Lambda a chance. I have to do this, Sharia, for a lot of reasons. So please, let me try. Look, this may not be a good plan, but it's all we've got. Are you with me?
All right, I'll leave this one to you. Besides, it's not like we could talk him out of it.
No, probably not.
He's been living with Lambda for like a year now, right? I honestly think he'll be fine. What about you, Richard?
Asbel, are you absolutely sure about this?
I am.
All right. The decision is made. We rest tonight and head out first thing in the morning.
Okay.
You need to find a way to set their minds at ease. Once we board the shuttle, we can't afford any last-minute regrets. Understand?
Asbel, if you turned into Lambda, I'd have to resume my mission.
That's not gonna happen. He's different from before. I know it's hard, but you just have to trust him.
Understandable that Sophie and Richard are apprehensive about this.
Trust Lambda.
Especially Richard. Classic humans make mistakes, etc. Little storyline. I don't really like... The Lineage and Legacy story is, like, fine. Definitely, like, it's not, like, anything groundbreaking. It's a nice little conclusion to the game. I really just think Lineage acts as, like, a good enough sequel for Graces because... Graces ended at a pretty good spot with the main arc. Like, obviously, like, I love the future arc too much to give up the future arc, but it ends at a good spot where, like, it didn't need to be a thing, but I'm glad it is. Like, overall, the story's, like, fine for the future arc. It's pretty short, too, so, like, it's not really, like, there's not really much story to review, but, like, it's overall pretty solid. It's a nice little conclusion to, like, Sophie's character and, like, just the overall premise in general.